Hey everybody, I'm Farron Cousins and you're watching The Daily Left, your interactive source for progressive news and commentary. Thanks for joining me. Today's top story, according to a new report, John McCain was very prone to mishaps during his time as a Navy pilot. Before entering the Navy, McCain scored very low on his aptitude tests, and many believe that he was only admitted because his father was a well-respected lieutenant. Over the course of his career, he crashed at least four different planes, which official military reports show were due to his own negligence. In Texas in 1960, he slammed into Corpus Christi Bay and sheared the skin off his plane's wings. In his autobiography, he claims that his engine failed, but the military said that he wasn't paying attention and caused the accident himself. They also said that there was absolutely no evidence of engine failure. In another incident, McCain was clowning around in a Sky Raider over southern Spain in December 1961 and flew into electrical wires, causing a blackout for the entire area. In 1965, McCain crashed a T-2 trainer jet in Virginia, and after he was sent to Vietnam, his plane was destroyed in an explosion on the deck of an aircraft carrier in 1967. You know, this raises serious questions about McCain's judgment and ability to perform even the slightest tasks. While his service to America is honorable and appreciated, his record isn't one that he should be proud of. And in other McCain news, in another story that most of the media has missed, John McCain's proposed health care plan would be paid for by significant cuts to Medicaid and Medicare. Independent analysts are estimating that, in order to fund McCain's health care plan, he would have to cut $1.3 trillion from those programs over the next 10 years. And that's on top of the $35 billion in cuts that Bush has imposed over the next 5 years. McCain's plan is to offer a new tax credit of $2,500 per person and $5,000 per family toward insurance premiums. This would allow people to buy health coverage in the open market, where they may have more choices and might look for a better bargain, according to McCain. In exchange, the government would begin taxing the value of health benefits people get through work. For example, if an employer spends $10,000 to buy a worker health insurance, the worker would pay taxes on that $10,000. This means that you will actually be paying more out of pocket. The McCain campaign has said that the tax credit would be paid for by increasing taxes elsewhere, but as we can clearly see, that's nowhere near the truth. And speaking of healthcare, a new study has revealed that free drug samples do little, if anything, to help the poor and might actually be putting our children at risk. Once in a doctor's office, children who lack health insurance are more likely to receive free drug samples than their well-insured counterparts. In 2004, the year that the study was conducted, more than 500,000 children received samples of four medicines that were later the subject of serious safety warnings. These free samples are a powerful marketing tool for pharmaceutical reps, and they use them as bargaining chips with doctors. But not all of the blame lies with the pharmaceutical companies, as many doctors will refuse to even meet with their reps if they don't have free samples with them. According to the watchdog group Public Citizen, this practice only encourages doctors to misuse drugs and give them to people who don't really need them. But in a time where millions of children are without health insurance, these dangerous pharmaceuticals might be all that they have access to, and under John McCain's plan, more children would have to rely on these free, often dangerous, drugs. And finally today, the Federal Reserve is currently debating whether or not to buy up the debt of major corporations in an effort to kickstart the economy again. Under a proposal being discussed with the Treasury Department, the Fed could buy vast amounts of unsecured short-term debt that companies rely on to finance their day-to-day activities. Lending has all but stopped thanks to our current financial crisis, but this idea would hardly be a long-term solution. And now, the economic trouble has begun to spread across the globe as stocks in Europe are plummeting as well. But pouring more money into failed corporations will do very little to help the average American worker. What we need is a bailout for the people who've lost their jobs and can no longer put food on the table, not a bailout for greedy CEOs who made bad decisions. And we can shore up the economy by imposing stricter regulations on businesses to help prevent another economic disaster. Throwing more money at the problem isn't going to solve anything. And that's the Daily Left for today. Feel free to leave a comment or you can email us at info@goleft.tv. I'm Farron Cousins and thanks for watching Go Left TV. Citizens Media on the rise.
Well, like John McCain says, I'm an expert on energy. Look, I'll show you. Drill, baby, drill. Drill, baby, drill.
But Governor Palin, you keep saying how great offshore drilling is, but Hurricane Ike caused at least 500,000 gallons of crude oil to spill into the Gulf of Mexico, causing massive environmental damage to Texas and Louisiana.
Oh, say it ain't so, Joe.
My name isn't Joe.
It's just a little spill, baby, spill. Spill, baby, spill. Spill, baby, spill. Call John. Tell him we got a new slogan.